coffee's ready if you have some. Breakfast should be finished soon. The paper called for sun tomorrow.
I was trying to make an artistic shot and the beans just went everywhere. Good morning everyone! Today is Thursday and it's a pretty normal day today, like I have no work. Actually, the thing with modeling or acting or really anything in the entertainment industry, I think, is your schedule is completely like sporadic and you never know what's going to go on. Sometimes you're crazy busy to the point where you're going to have a breakdown, and sometimes there's absolutely nothing. So yeah, no work today, it's just going to be me, you, basically doing nothing, so I hope you're up for that. And yeah, let's have a good day together. More of a natural makeup look, and I don't really feel like wearing contact lenses today, so I just threw on these glasses. I think they're kind of cute. And so now I'm just gonna go and do my nails. I haven't done my nails in so long, so I'm gonna get a nice gel manicure and do some nail art on them. So whenever I go to get my nails done, I always plan out the design of what I want to do. So that is what I'm doing now. I always like go like this. I sort of draw out both hands and then I plan each nail so that I can get the idea from my head onto the paper so I can clearly explain it, because my Japanese isn't that great to like fully explain every detail, I guess. So this time I'm thinking I want something spring, summerish, probably pink or a light red color and white. That always matches well, and I think I want to do something like with fruit, maybe strawberries or something, because that's kind of springish. And there's like a little trend going on I've seen recently where girls will paint the inside of their nail, like a inner circle one color, and it fades out to white. I might do that. Yeah, you'll see what I'm talking about if I do it later. Here is my outfit today. I have these sort of baggy jeans on that I got at Topshop. And I got this sweater in Shibuya 109. I forget the store, but I will link it below. So yeah, it's a very chill and relaxed, casual day. Oh, and my bag. The bag I'm wearing today is the Chanel Boy one in a navy blue. Here's one side and here's the other. They're basically the same, except I put two strawberries on this side and I put two strawberries on this side and one strawberry on the other. There we go. Yay! My nail artist actually told me that these nails are called cheek nails because they look like cheeks. Really adorable, and I'm really happy with them. And now I'm going to head to a vegan grocery store. Well, I think it sells vegan food and like organic healthy food in the grocery store. Hopefully it does. I haven't been there before, but I'm gonna go check it out now. And oh, but before that, I'm gonna eat lunch because I'm starving. So I'm gonna have a late lunch at this vegan cafe nearby the grocery store. I'm in Hiro right now, by the way.
So
This place is mostly famous for their acai bowls, but I was feeling like something a little bit more savory, so I didn't get that one. I got the vegetable rice bowl instead. And I also got the acai strawberry banana smoothie. There's rice at the bottom there. Just finished lunch, it was absolutely delicious, and now I'm heading to that grocery store. I actually want to buy some asahi now because that smoothie was amazing. I love the taste, and it was like full of omega fatty acids and antioxidants. Oh my god, guys, oh my god. For the first time ever, I found gluten-free vegan pizza. This like doesn't exist here.
This is amazing.
They have these Amy's pizzas. Here's one with no cheese for vegans and roasted vegetables. Oh my god, I'm so happy right now. I'm gonna buy all these, but I'm gonna save these for later because they're frozen, so I'm gonna pick them up last. I'm so happy.
Everything looks so good, I don't even know where to start. Everywhere I look, there's like,
hummus, tahini, veggie burgers. Oh, everything looks so good. Oh my god, I need to grab a cart because there's too many things.
Shopping is done, and now I thought I would do a grocery haul. Maybe you guys would be interested in sort of the vegan stuff that I bought today. I would be certainly interested in it because I didn't know that this type of store existed, and I just found it by surprise by searching for stuff on Google. But yeah, maybe I should clear up first of all what my diet is like, because I get so many questions about, are you vegan, are you gluten-free, do you eat meat, do you eat this, do you eat that. So I'm going to clear that up right now. I'm not vegan, however, I try to eat mostly a plant-based diet. I'm kind of scared of using the term vegan because I feel like if I slip up now and again, sometimes the vegan community can be quite harsh, and not only with food, but if I use some product or makeup, etc., etc. And it's especially hard with me for work because I work with all kinds of makeup artists or whatever, so I can't control what products they use, and then also whatever they give me for lunch, I kind of have to eat and not be so fussy. They know not to give me red meat because I obviously don't eat that, but usually there is some sort of fish product in everything here. Like, they even cook their vegetables in like this like stock that has a fish base. So it's kind of really tricky to avoid here, especially if you're working and that sort of thing. That being said, I do try to eat mostly plant-based. However, I do eat fish and sushi sometimes. I'd say like 80-90% of my week is plant-based unless I'm working a lot. So I do try to do that. It's been really hard to like be completely vegan here because, like I said, I didn't find a vegan grocery store anywhere. It's been hard to find gluten-free things too. There's like a few vegan cafes that are popping up now, so it's making it easier, and I share a lot of those in my vlogs or videos, so you'll kind of come to know them if you watch a lot of my videos. So crazy happy to have found this grocery store. So Okay, so I'm basically mostly plant-based, 80%. I definitely don't eat red meat, no beef, no pork. I do eat fish sometimes. I don't eat dairy, like I don't like drinking milk. I read too much about it with all the chemicals and hormones that are pumped into it, and I do feel like it's like another animal's pus. And and when you think about it, a lot of people say this, and it's true. Cows produce milk to feed their baby cows, and it helps them to grow really fast and big. So why would we want to drink another animal's milk that makes it grow up big and fast. We don't need to grow anymore as adults. And as babies, we need to drink our own mother's milk, but we certainly don't need to drink another animal's milk then or even now. So yeah, I don't drink milk. I find when, I mean, sometimes I do slip up. I'll have an ice cream or I'll have a piece of chocolate or something. Like if I do, it's not the end of the world. I try to avoid it. I feel much better and like less bloated when I don't eat it. I am also gluten-free. I am gluten intolerant, so you'll find I'm always searching for gluten-free options. A lot of you notice in my videos that I always eat gluten-free or ask if there's wheat and things or and so on. So yeah, I am gluten-free. So I'm red meat-free and gluten-free for sure. I try to be dairy-free as often as I can, and I try to be plant-based as often as I can, especially when I'm cooking for myself. All right, that being said, I hope that answers all of your questions about my diet. So I'm going to show you now what I bought. I didn't buy any produce or fruit, like no fruit and vegetables and that sort of thing there because I have so many bags and it was just way too heavy to carry. So I'll just get all that at my supermarket nearby, and I do still have some stuff in the fridge. So if you're wondering why I don't have any fruit or vegetables, that's why. So first of all, I bought a lot of canned beans. In most supermarkets in Japan, you can't actually find these canned beans. You'll often find them dried and bagged, so which is fine, but I never know what I'm gonna cook like the night before, and for those you have to like soak in water the night before so that they're ready the next day for you to cook with. And yeah, I never know when I'm gonna be cooking that sort of stuff, so I just like to have these on hand. And actually I'm gonna need these for tonight because I'm gonna be making a really yummy recipe, which I will tell you about later. So I got black beans, I got garbanzo beans. I don't know if I have chickpeas. Is that a chickpea? Is that the same thing? I don't really know. Black beans, chili beans, kidney beans. I got like two. Oh, and I got some sliced beets. I've never even found a raw beet in the supermarket nearby me, let alone like a canned beet, so I grabbed those. Oh, and these are wheat-free, vegan, dairy-free ramen noodles. So I really want to try and make like a vegan ramen. I gotta think of how I'm gonna do the broth, but yeah, hopefully I can figure out something yummy, and if I do, then I will definitely share my recipe with you guys. Done one bag. Ah, the pizzas. So I have searched everywhere. There isn't even a restaurant that serves gluten-free pizza. If there is in Japan and you know, please tell me, because I feel like I've searched every forum, website, like everywhere to find gluten-free pizza, supermarket, and I haven't been able to find it. And I finally found it there. So I grabbed this. It is pizza made with rice flour and sorghum flour. It's vegan and gluten-free and additive-free, and it's absolutely amazing, and I'm so excited. I bought three of them. I can't wait to try this. These are my favorite noodles. They're rice and corn macaroni. Look at that. They're really delicious to make like with vegan cheese or pesto sauce or tomato sauce. I like it anyway. I love these. Yeah, I grabbed two bags of these. Then I got some gluten-free pancake and waffle mix. I got some kale chips, which are Bombay curry flavor. I should come closer. Oh, my hair is just like tilting to the side.
I got my favorite nighttime tea by Clipper. It's called Snore and Peace. It's organic chamomile, I don't know, lemon balm, and lavender. Whenever I see this, I pick it up because I go through it like crazy. I really love this one. I got some gluten-free pizza and pastry multi-mix so that I can make homemade pizzas, which is something I often do with my family. So yeah, it kind of reminds me of home, so I want to make those. So the restaurant that I just ate at, I actually found the same brand, Sambazon of acai. So I bought the powder so that I can make it myself in the morning. I think it would be really nice to make a acai bowl, like with a acai smoothie at the bottom. Yeah, I'm gonna try that. I got some organic tomato sauce for my pasta, my pizza sauce. I found gluten-free soy sauce, which is really important because a lot of things here have soy sauce. So yeah, if you are gluten-free, then you can find this soy sauce at this store. Oh, I should say the name again. It is National Azabu, and it's in Hiro. I will link the website below so that you guys can find it easy. You gotta go. Vegan butter! That's vegan butter if you didn't understand that. Alright, next up. What I found, dairy-free cream cheese. Yes, I can have a bagel. Gluten-free buns. Oh, apparently I got another pancake and waffle mix that's gluten-free. Okay, I'm so excited for these. Dairy-free cheese. This one is mozzarella and this one is medium cheddar. I'm gonna use this one tonight. Last one. I got some veggie burgers. I got gluten-free pancakes, which are already made. These are like ready. I can just heat them up and put some yummy toppings on them, like the vegan butter or I don't know, like, oh, I have maple syrup too, right from Canada. I'm gonna have these tomorrow morning. And I got some organic corn, which I'm gonna use tonight. And finish! Oh, there is ice in there. I always just throw some. I have so many teas in my tea cupboard and they're like just everywhere. So I always just like throw it in and shut the door fast, hoping nothing will fall down after me, which it just did. But whew, I really need to fix that cupboard. All right, so for dinner tonight, I'm going to be making a vegan chili. Now, I haven't had chili in so long, but it's not that warm today. It's kind of cool and I'm really feeling like a really cozy night in to relax with a nice warm bowl of chili, and I want to catch up with Game of Thrones because I've missed a few episodes now. So I just want to, actually I like doing that. I like waiting and letting the episodes build up so that I can watch a few in a row, because one episode of Game of Thrones is just never enough. It always leaves you hanging and you always want to see more. So anyways, I'm going to make a vegan chili with you guys, and I just have to go and grab a few items that I need from the grocery store, and then we'll start cooking together. Okay, so while this is cooking up on low heat for about 30 more minutes, I'm going to make the toppings for the chili bowl. So I'm going to do a guacamole, and then I'm going to chop up some lettuce and some vegan shredded cheddar cheese. So it's dairy-free cheese. So to make guacamole, it's so easy. You just cut an avocado in half carefully, and then if you get it right, you can remove the pit without. There, got it. Just take out all the inside, all that avocado goodness. And then you just want to take a fork and mash it until it becomes like all soft and mushy and mixed together. There we go. You can make it as smashed or as smooth as you want it. If you leave a little chunks, it's okay too. Then I'm gonna add the juice of about half of a lime. If you're gonna eat something that's salty, like those salted corn chips, or like this has a bit of salt in it too, and the corn chips that I'm gonna add have a bit of salt in it, then you don't really need to add more here. I'm just gonna make this really simple, just pure avocado, a little bit of lime to give it a little bit of zesty, tangy taste, and that's all that there is to it. Mix that all in. Perfect. I'm just gonna give this a stir. You wanna stir it every now and again.
All right, so I got some guacamole, some vegan cheddar cheese. I just used the grater to grate that, and then I sliced up some iceberg lettuce, and these are some corn chips. I got these ones. It's actually the Kirkland brand, which is the Costco brand. And these are my favorite corn chips, so I'm so glad I found them. And I found them at the Azabu International Supermarket. It's called Nissen. I will also link that below. Come in a huge bag though, like definitely Costco size, but I just love them and I eat them all the time. And while that's cooking, I'm gonna give Rosie a bath because I think there's an extra 20 minutes left.
Oh yeah, that looks perfect. Look at that, it's all ready. Oh yeah, look at that. I'm gonna top with some shredded lettuce on this corner. And then cheese, big gallop of guacamole, look at that. Okay, how good does that look? And I just have some chips on the side here to dip to if I want. Alright guys, I'm just gonna eat this now while watching Game of Thrones. I can't wait to devour this. So I'm gonna just say goodnight now because I'm just gonna watch that and then probably just chill. I might watch like 2 or 3 episodes like I said before. So yeah, I will say goodnight now. Thanks for spending the day with me and I hope you enjoyed this vlog. Give it a thumbs up if you did. If you try out this recipe, be sure to tag me or let me know how it turns out. Alright, goodnight!